Reforms to overhaul the Reserve Bank will be introduced to Parliament next week, with the inflation fight becoming the federal government's key focus for the second half of its term. The central bank shake-up getting underway as the opposition leader delivers an early pitch to voters being crushed by the soaring cost of living.
An Aussie staple on the Christmas table, but festive feasts will cost far more this year.
Fighting inflation is absolutely the priority of the Albanese government.
On top of the supermarket shop, insurance and energy bills continue to rise, and tonight petrol prices are on a knife's edge as conflict in the Middle East looms over oil-producing nations.
We know that Australian households and businesses are doing it tough.
But they shouldn't expect to see a Christmas bonus fuel tax cut.
But we've got to ensure that what we do is sustainable from a fiscal point of view.
Homeowners, though, will hear less from the central bank in the new year. Major reforms recommended by the government's RBA review in April will be introduced to Parliament next week. A new board will handle day-to-day operations and payment systems, including Apple Pay. And the existing board will meet less often, 11 monthly meetings reduced to 8, each over 2 days. It means there'll be a little more conversation and a little less action on interest rates, but the government is still at odds with the central bank over where inflation is coming from.
The remaining inflation challenge we're dealing with is increasingly homegrown and demand-driven.
And what Australia is experiencing is what every other country in the world is experiencing.
But if Australians continue to cop what they've endured through the first half of this term, they'll judge Labor on its second half, and at full time, that's what the opposition will be counting on.
There is a huge Whitlam-style mess being created now that we will have to clean up when we're elected in 2025.
Peter Dutton making an early pitch at the New South Wales Liberal Conference.
So do I think this is a bad government capable of being replaced after 3 years? You bet. You bet.
Mortgage holders, renters and struggling families will decide. Rhys D'Alessandro, Nine News.